We already started with the first chapter as an introduction to the cloud computing. Okay, so basically cloud is nothing but a one kind of server or one kind of a database which is stored on a remote location. Okay, so cloud computing, it is a one kind of model through which user can access the personal information via the internet or via the networking device. Okay, so today we will discuss about the evolution of the cloud computing. Before cloud computing came, the different types of modules are present. So what are those modules? So as we can see in the figure, cluster computing, which was present in the 1980s, and the grid computing as well as utility computing, and the
ma'am, your voice is continuously breaking.
Now it is okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So in the evolution of cloud computing, we will discuss about the cluster computing, grid computing, utility computing, and the software as a service provider, which means these are the cloud computing providers as well as the cloud computing concept also. Okay, so we start with the first as a cluster computing. So this figure shows the graph how the way the cloud computing is to be evaluated. So this is the evolution of the cloud computing. So we'll start with the cluster computing. So this is the definition of the cluster computing. So cluster, see in this figure. Now this virtual whiteboard is visible to all of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we can see here the cluster computing as well as utility and the grid computing. So go for the first cluster computing. As we can see in the figure, these are the number of computers. This number of computers, or we can say the bunch of computers, or this single C1 computer, I called it as it is a Maya one cluster. So C1, C2, C3 and the C4. So these four computers or the clusters, I called it as these are the bunch of the clusters. So one single computer is a one kind of node or the cluster. So cluster computing is nothing but a one kind of computing model in which the bunch of the computers or the nodes are connected through a local area network. So we can see the group of computers are there, or we can say the nodes or the clusters in the form of a cluster computing. So all these computers or the clusters are connected to the one kind of device. So that device is our local area network. So that all this bunch of computers, they behave like a single machine, or in the word of clustering, I called it as this all group of computers, they have behaved like as a server, as a centralized server. So this centralized server is to be maintained or is to be managed or controlled by the all this number of clusters. So this, the cluster computing, it is a one kind of computing model in which bunch of computers or the clusters, or we can say the nodes, are connected through a local area network, so that they act as or behave like a single machine or the centralized server. As we can see in the figure, all this group of computers are connected to the local area network. So this group, I called it as it is a centralized type of a server, because they are acts like a server for the by grouping of these clusters. Okay, so why they are grouping? Because if they are grouping in a one kind of servers, no, they act like a high in availability. So if one of the requests is satisfied by the C1, if the request is not done by the C1 computer or the cluster, that request is moved to the C2 computer. If one of the request is want to done by the C, one of the example. So this is the user. This user is requested to the this C2 computer, one kind of resource or one kind of service which is to be set by with the this user. So that request is send it to the C2 computer. Then C2 computer, it will check whether the resource or the service or the any kind of application is present in this C2 device. If it is not, then that is goes to the another C3 and again goes to the C2. So all these conditions has to be controlled by the centralized server. So it is a one kind of model in which bunch of computers are connected via the local area network. So I can say, so all these cluster computers are high in availability. So whatever the load of for the particular clusters are there, that load is to be balanced for each and every clusters. So they can perform the any particular job or the request parallelly. So I can say they perform the parallel processing job. Okay. So the advantage of cluster computing. So it is a very good in a high availability. Load balancing is also done, as well as the particular request or the job is to be performed parallelly. Okay. So one of the best example of the cluster computing is a game console clusters. So first example is a Sony PlayStation clusters and the Microsoft Xbox clusters. So these games are some with the advent virtualization. It means the Sony PlayStation clusters as well as the Microsoft Xbox clusters. These both kind of game console clusters, they use the virtualization layer. So it means these clusters, whatever the virtual layers they are using for the cluster nodes, they run on a separate physical computers with the different operating system. It means this kind of clusters or the this kind of console clusters, they are using the virtualization concept. So what do you mean by that virtualization concept? We will discuss in the coming sessions. Okay. So in short, the cloud cluster is nothing but the group of computers are connected via the local area network, so that they acts like a one kind of single machine, or we can say that it is a one kind of server also. Okay. So whatever the jobs or the requests are done, that kind of jobs are to be performed parallelly, one by one, or we can say the parallelly also, simultaneously, concurrently. Okay. So this is the one kind of computing, cluster computing in the evaluation of the cloud computing. So this is all about the cluster computing. Okay. So this is the cluster computing. As we can see in the figure, this is also the one example. See in the figure. So this is the form of a computing in which group of computers are linked together so that they act as a single entity. Okay, so they can be connected through a local area network so that the whatever the jobs or the task is performed a parallelly processing. Okay, so this is the one kind of example as well as the figure. See here also. So this is the definition. A cluster computing which consists of a set of loosely connected computers. So what do you mean by that loosely connected computer? See in this figure. So this is the example how computers are loosely connected. Okay. So this consider as a local, this whole figure, this whole one rectangle, we called it as a, this is a one processor or this is a one machine. This is a single machine and so on. So for this single machine where the local memory and the CPU they are itself is having. So all the number of computers or the processors, they are connected via the communication network. Okay. So whatever the in communication they want to perform in between via the message passing concept. If one of the computers they want to communicate or want to share the resources with the another computers, they are using the message passing concept. So in the loosely coupled systems, they are just sharing the communication network. Okay. And the communication is done via the message passing. Okay. And this is the another example, tightly coupled system. So in this tightly coupled system, we can see the every computer number of multiprocessors are connected via the communication network, but they are sharing the one secondary device memory. So memory is to be shared among the number of computers. In the loosely coupled, each and every computer is having their own local memories. But in a tightly coupled, each and every computers or the processors, they are sharing their memory. So this is the difference between the loosely coupled and the tightly coupled. So what they are saying in the cluster computing, so cluster computing, it is a set of loosely coupled computers, obviously. So it is a collection of personal computers. So I can say it is a collection of loosely connected computers so that they work together via a single machine. So each and one single machine or the single node, I called it as a, it is a cluster. So cluster computing, it is a combination of all cluster, so it is a cluster computing. So master computing, this is also called as a master computing. So this is the one example or the figure. So this is the loosely coupled system as well as the difference between the tightly coupled systems. So this is also the one example. The number of computers are connected via the one device. We called it as a switch. So all these computers are connected via the local area network. So they can be shared by the service provider one as well as the service provider two. So, okay. So whatever the jobs or the request as well as the services has to be satisfied by the this local area network. So it means the job has to be performed parallelly for each and every computer. So this is all about the clustering computing. Any problem from this? Is there any problem from the cluster computing?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so going to the next, utility computing. So utility computing, so see in this figure. Okay, so this is my virtual whiteboard. See in this figure, there's a utility computing. So in this utility computing, so this is the one kind of a model in which computing resources are provided the customer based via specific demand. Okay, now see this same example. The customer, this customer, or we can say that this customer also. Okay, so number of computers are connected. Okay, so one of the customer, he wants request for one kind of resource or the service to the specific this centralized server. So in that case, in utility computing, so it is a one kind of computing model in which computing resources or the services are provided to the customer according to their specific requirement or according to their specific demand. What kind of resources as well as the what kind of demand is there, according to that utility computing model is provided to that kind of request to the server, it requested to the user. So the service provided charges according to the exactly for the services provided. So what kind of service is to be provided by this utility computing, that according to that service it will get the charges according to the service provider. So it is a one kind of model in which computing resources are provided to the customer. Okay, see here. So in the utility computing model, computing resources like applications or the storage devices as well as the services, they can charges according to the pay per use. The users paying only for what they consume, like the electricity. So similarly, it is similar for the cloud computing. So how much services we have used, that kind of service we will charges it. In many respects, the cloud computing is closely related to the utility computing model. So these are the examples for the utility computing model. So Amazon provider as well as the Google provider and the Microsoft Azure. So just now I said this utility computing model is little bit similar to the cloud computing. So how much data we are using, so user have to pay that kind of data. Okay, so it is based on a pay per use or a share per use model. Okay, so see in this example here. So in utility computing, the centralized server is present. This model requires the computing resources which is provided to the user. So the four computers are connected via this centralized server. So any number of computers they are requesting to the particular service to the server. So in that case, that resources or the services is written back is in the form of a result to the servers or the users. So this I call it as a, it is my utility computing model. So this computing model is little bit similar to the cloud computing. So how much you are using, so that kind of pay we will with the customers. So this is the one example for the cloud computing. Okay, so this is the one example. So these are the three examples: Amazon, Google and the Microsoft Azure. So this is also the one example how the centralized server or the management server or the master node is performing all kinds of jobs or the all kinds of requests. So just now I said, so the cloud versus utility computing. In the utility computing, now we are sharing the resources. Okay, but in a cloud computing, we can ask for the particular kind of service that can be provided by the cloud computing services. So this is the one difference in the cloud as well as the utility computing. Now next is a grid computing. So this is the one example, grid computing. So grid computing, it is a group of network computers. So it is a networking computers which work together as a virtual supercomputer. So that they can perform a large task such as analysis of the huge set of data. So we can see in this figure. So this whole block, this whole rectangle, I called it as a, it is a grid. So grid computing, it is a group of networked computers. Okay, so they work together as a virtual supercomputer. As we can see in this rectangle, where the multiple computers are connected via the networking device. Okay, and so all grid machines, they are maintained or controlled by the one of the grid server. So this grid server which control, manages and as well as perform the administrative duties by this grid server. So whatever the control for the particular services, managing the resources as well as observing the what kind of applications and the resources, all applications or the all responsibilities and the duties has to be done by this grid server. So simply grid server, it is a group of networked computers which worked together as a virtual supercomputer so that they perform a large kind of task or the large kind of jobs such as the analysis of large or the huge set of data. Okay, so one characteristic or the one property of this grid computing is the resources has to be shared among the number of grids. The resources in a grid must be connected or the coordinator in order to perform the aggregated computing capabilities. Means I want to say, so whatever the resources are there, that kind of resources among these grid machines is to be shared and that resources has to be coordinated with each other. So this is the one characteristics of the grid machine, is a resources has to be coordinated via the sharing. So another characteristic of the grid machine is a transparent access. So grid should be seen as a single virtual computer. So for this grid server, they can show it as a one single machine. So they can I call it as a, it is a transparent access. A grid should be a seen as a single virtual computers. Okay, it is also one dependable access. A grid must access the delivery of the services under the service requirement. Okay, so this grid computing, I also called it as a, it is my distributed computing, because the number of computers or the processes are connected with each other. Okay, and they are just sharing their resources, services, as well as the request also. So I can say, since this grid computing is also called as a distributed computing. Okay, so it is a, see here, so grid computing, it is a form of a distributed computing whereby resources of many computers in a network is used at the same time. So whatever the resources or the applications are there, that resources is to be shared among the network via this grid machines, because they are connected via the distributed networking device. This is the one diagram through which you can easily understand what do you mean by grid computing. So this each machine, I called it as a, it is a grid machine. So this whole block, I called it as a, this is a my a distributed grid machine. So this distributed grid machine can be controlled and can be handled or maintained by one of the grid server. So whatever the jobs are there, that jobs are performed parallelly, one after the another, or the one by one also. It means they are performing the job as a parallelly. So this is the one definition as well as the explanation about this grid computing. So I can say the grid computing, which is a high in a scalability. Scalability means, so one of the load or the job is to be distributed among the multiple computers. So I can say the job is to be scalable. So job is to be divided into the multiple computers. So this is the high in scalability, high in flexibility also, because the job is to be distributed among the computers. So obviously each and every computer's performance is increases. So it is a high in availability, high in reliability, as well as high in flexibility also. It is also cost effective. Okay, so it is in a decentralized model. So grid computing is also called as a decentralization model. Okay, so it is a great in high availability, high reliability, scalability, as well as the flexibility, because each and every job is to be distributed among the number of computers. Okay, so grid computing is also called as a distributed computing. So this is all about the grid computing model. So see here this one example. So the number of computers or the processors are connected via the network, and this whole grid clients or the machines has to be maintained or handled by this grid server. So one of the user, any kind of users, they want to access, and that kind of request is to be performed parallelly. So this also called as a scalability job. So this is how grid computing is works. So see here, so what I'm just saying, no, this is the grid computing is a distributed networking model. So this is the one differentiate between the centralized network as well as the distributed network. So in this centralized network, all computers or the processes are connected via this centralized servers. Okay, if suppose this centralized server has failed down, the all networking has to be disturbed. So it is not in case with the distributed networking model. Okay, each and every user is having their own server or is having their own local memory. Okay, so you, for this user one, the server is present. So this server, the another user can access the this kind of server. So I can say this is the tightly coupled system also. Okay, so each and every customers having their own local memory as well as the servers. The memory is shared among the multiple computers. The server is shared, the server data is shared among the multiple computers or the users. So this is the one difference. What do you mean by centralized network as well as the distributed network? So we have just done. What do you mean by our evolution of cloud computing? Okay, so this is about the cluster computing, grid computing, utility computing, and this is the cloud computing providers. So this section we will discuss in the next session, and this is the last one, is a cloud computing. So cloud computing, we already know what we mean by cloud computing. So it is a one kind of model which provides the different kinds of services as well as resources according to the user's requirement via the networking or the internet. So this is all about the evolution of the cloud computing. And these are the examples how the cluster computing, cloud computing as well as the grid computing is performed. Okay, so in cluster computing, number of clusters are connected so that they act like a server. Okay, in a utility computing, the request is sent to the one kind of centralized server. In response, they will give is a that kind of result to the respective user. So I can say this is the client server model also. And the grid computing, it is a distributed server. Okay, so number of computers are connected via the network. Okay, so that the jobs are shared among the multiple servers. So that can be handled by the grid server. And this is the cloud computing. So this is all about the evolution of the cloud computing.